Thank you all for coming tonight. On March 28, 2008, 9 third graders way across Georgia were arrested after it was revealed that they were plotting to kill their teacher for disciplining a student standing on a desk. Some of the 8 or 9 year olds have been expelled and others face juvenile charges. Luckily, Magic Pants was able to obtain a transcript of the events of that fateful day and will present them to you tonight, thus fulfilling our court mandated community service. Enjoy.
Now class, 5 times 8 is
40.
40.
Now Carol, I hardly think that outburst was necessary. Try to keep those to a minimum. Now class, if you'll excuse me, I have to go to the office and get your social studies quizzes before it closes. Be good while I'm gone, all right, children?
Today is a glorious day, comrades. Today is the day that we emerge from beneath her jackbooted heel. Now, does everyone have their stuff?
I brought the blunt object.
I brought the tape.
I stole a kitchen knife from my house.
I brought the ribbon.
Ribbon? Ribbon, you fool. I hate to say it, Sadie, but I seriously question your commitment to this revolution.
I thought we could tie our hands with a ribbon, and I mean, if we're gonna stab her, we need something to clean it up with. Am I right?
I will never, never succeed to this ridiculous request. This floor will be stained with the color of freedom. Do you understand? Besides, everyone here knows that ribbon is for sissies, and if you use it, you're stupid and a girl. Right?
Yeah, look, I'm a stupid girl. I clean up blood with ribbon and lace curtains.
Haley, my love, I simply had to speak to you before the struggle. I fear that this is going to take a long time before we're united again, and I have to see your broken cheeks.
Oh, don't speak like that. We can be together if we only wish it. We may be separated by walls, but they'll never separate us.
Asses! Ha ha! You have the same butt! You have the same butt!
Haley, my sweetness, I fear the struggle will be a long and bloody one. But, I got a present for you. It's a bunch of worms and the tail of a lizard. It's still moving, see? Cool, huh?
Oh, Bradley.
All right, class. Let's get started with your quiz, all right?
Oh, my stomach hurts real bad. I think I got lumbago in the appendix. Teacher, my epidural is bleeding.
If I didn't know any better, I think you kids were gonna kill me. Yes, I think you little rascals are gonna work me to death. Well, come on, Jacob, let's take you to the nurse's office and make you all better, all right? Let's go.
All right, let's go over the timeline again. 10:22.
I hit her over the head with a blunt object, birds fly around her head, and she falls down.
10:24. I tape up her hands and feet. She's surprised, but not mad at me. 10:30.
We break for snacks and juice.
Yay! I brought ding-dongs and Hawaiian punch.
Yeah. I bought my Hannah Montana DVD. We can all watch it while we're eating.
Oh, we can watch it while we poo.
I'm afraid Daryl's right. Hannah Montana is a dumb face and should die.
Listen, everybody, I managed to give her the slip. Now hurry, we don't have much time.
All right, 10:40.
Okay, I stab her with a knife a couple of times. She only bleeds for a little while, but then she realizes she's been a jerk to us and she's been treating us like second graders.
Yeah!
Then we'll get respect around here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah, that's right. But why are we doing this again?
Because that one time she made Bradley get down off his chair, remember? Yeah!
Yeah!
That's right!
Yeah.
I told Mrs. Norris and Principal Goober about the revolution because you guys are all jerks. You can make fun of me! Never mind Hannah and Montana.
Six, seven, tyrannus!
Ah!